This is the Three Gorges Dam, the most powerful dam on the planet. Look at the size of it, and then imagine something twice as big. That's what one country is planning to build. Not China or America, not Japan or Australia. The country behind this record-breaking project, a mega dam large enough to power almost half a continent, is the Democratic Republic of the Congo. You've probably heard of this country, but you might not know much about it. In terms of area, it's actually the second largest country in Africa and the 11th largest country in the entire world. It's home to 95 million people, more than Germany, France, or the United Kingdom, not to mention a spectacular range of wildlife, like elephants and chimpanzees. It's easy to confuse the Democratic Republic of the Congo, also known as the DRC, with the Republic of the Congo, which sits next door. These countries share some similarities. The official language in both countries is French, bonjour, and the main religion in both countries is Christianity. And most notably, both places were named after the Congo River, which formed a border between the two. And this border is pretty unique. When you look at this map, it probably looks like a single city. At least it does until you notice that there aren't any bridges across the river. You're actually looking at two cities, Brazzaville in the Republic of the Congo and Kinshasa in the DRC. They're the closest pair of capital cities in the entire world. There are plans to build a $400 million bridge between the two cities to cross the river, but that project hasn't started yet. Speaking of which, let's talk a bit more about the Congo River, which is the future site of Africa's $80 billion mega dam.
We have now recommitted ourselves to reviving the Grand Inga Project.
The Congo is one of the largest rivers on the planet, but it doesn't get as much attention as it probably deserves. When people talk about giant rivers, they'll usually bring up the Nile, the Yangtze, or the Amazon. And while it's true that these rivers are longer than the Congo from one end to another, length isn't the only way to measure a river's size. Far from it. The Congo is the deepest river in the world. To put that into perspective, here's the tallest building in Brazzaville, and here's the tallest building in Kinshasa. You could stack these towers on top of each other, drop them into the Congo River, and there'd still be room to spare. The Congo River is also massive in terms of discharge. That's the amount of water that flows along it every single second. The Congo's discharge is 10 times bigger than the nearby Nile, 1.5 times bigger than the Yangtze in China, and okay, in terms of discharge, the Congo still can't compete with the Amazon, but to be honest, no rivers can. If you added together the total discharge of the Congo, the Yangtze, and the Nile, and then doubled that number, it would still be less than the amount of water that flows along the Amazon. But we still haven't mentioned the Congo River's most important feature. Welcome to Inga Falls. A short way downriver from Brazzaville and Kinshasa, there's a 15-kilometer stretch of water that drops by almost 100 meters. This drop creates a massive stretch of powerful, fast-moving water. It's technically the world's largest waterfall, but this title is a little controversial. Some people say that the Inga Falls aren't steep enough to be considered a true waterfall, and that it would be better to call them the Inga Rapids instead. Either way, this is the biggest and most powerful stretch of whitewater in the world. A few years ago, an extreme adventurer, Steve Fisher, managed to kayak all the way down the Inga Falls, but he almost drowned in the process. A few decades earlier, a team of French kayakers tried it too, and all seven of them were unfortunately killed. A staggering amount of fast-moving water comes crashing through here every second. In the context of the hydroelectric dams, it's a lot of potential energy. Experts believe there's enough water in Inga to generate almost 40 gigawatts of energy. That's almost 50 times more than the entire population of the DRC is currently using, and enough to power a bunch of other African countries too. People have been talking about Inga's potential for over 100 years, since a survey found that the Congo had more than 1/4 of the world's potential water power. So in the 1950s, Belgium already made plans to dam the Inga, but was forced to give up on those plans when the DRC earned its independence. But the idea of damming the Inga Falls didn't go away. Fast forward a few years later, and the DRC's new government ordered the construction of a 6-turbine dam, which became known as Inga 1. A few years later, they ordered the construction of an 8-turbine dam, which became known as, you guessed it, Inga 2. Together, these dams had the capacity to produce almost 2 gigawatts of energy, which helped to power some important industries, like copper mines in the country's south. But ultimately, the Inga 1 and 2 were barely scratching the surface. They were built on a side stream of the Inga Falls, as opposed to the thunderous main body of water, and they harnessed less than 5% of the Inga's total potential. That was 50 years ago. Today, the capacity of the Inga dams is even lower. Inga 1 and 2 have understandably degraded over time, and the DRC has struggled to maintain them. The costs are just far too high. They're not the only country with this problem. Very recently, 2 badly maintained dams in Libya, in northern Africa, collapsed after a storm and killed several thousand people. At the moment, Inga 1 and 2 aren't showing any signs of collapse, but they're barely operating at 30% of their original generation capacity. Over the past few years, there have been several plans to fix them up, with promises of backing from international companies like Siemens in Germany. There's also the proposal to build a third dam, the Inga 3, which could generate an extra 4.5 gigawatts. But these plans are nothing compared to another idea that the government has for the Congo River, and it's time to introduce their groundbreaking proposal, the Grand Inga Dam. Earlier, we mentioned how the Inga Falls have the potential to generate 40 gigawatts of energy. That's more than 20 times the current capacity of Inga 1 and 2. And the Grand Inga Dam is a staggering plan to harness every last drop. The plan looks like this. First, a giant wall will be built at the southern end of the Bundi Valley, which runs alongside the Inga Falls. This wall will be 200 meters long and block the bottom of the valley like a plug at the bottom of a bath. It will be fitted with 6 individual power stations, each with enough hydroelectric turbines to generate somewhere between 4 and 8 gigawatts of power. Next, another wall will be built at the top of the Inga Falls. This wall will divert the flow of the rapids into the Bundi Valley, filling it up like a giant tub. When the water reaches the wall at the southern end of the valley, gravity will send it crashing through the turbines of the 6 power plants, generating a total of 40 gigawatts of power. Plenty of places have redirected rivers into artificial reservoirs as a way to generate power, but what makes the Grand Inga stand out from the rest is its record-breaking size. It would generate more than twice as much power as the Three Gorges Dam, which is currently the most powerful dam in the world. It's enough to transform the African continent, where almost 50% of the population doesn't even have access to electricity. Of course, the construction costs for such a massive dam would be astronomical. It's expected to cost in the region of $80 billion, which is significantly more than the DRC's annual GDP. This raises an important question. Can the DRC even afford to build it? On their own? Probably not. The country can barely afford to maintain the dams at Inga 1 and 2, let alone construct a brand new project as large as the Grand Inga. In other words, there's a very good chance that this project never happens. But the dam starts to feel a lot more likely if we take into account the potential for foreign investment. As we already mentioned, the project could provide electrical energy to other parts of Africa. And several countries, including South Africa and Nigeria, have already declared an official interest in paying for a cut of the Grand Inga's power. There are suggestions that each of the dam's 6 power plants could be paid for by a different foreign investor who could own that power plant in return. The World Bank, the European Investment Bank, and the African Development Bank have also offered money to the project. As well as this, the DRC has earned the support of the African Union, who work to support cooperation between different African countries. That sounds like a great amount of support, but despite all of that, there are no guarantees. Even if these collaborations find a way to raise $80 billion, that still might not be enough to finish the dam. The majority of dams cost significantly more than their original projections. A lot of them cost double, which means that the Grand Inga Dam could actually end up costing closer to $160 billion. There's also a massive corruption problem in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. With government officials taking bribes and siphoning other important funds, it makes it even less likely that $80 billion would be enough to finish the project. And there are also other issues to worry about. Relocating more than 30,000 local villagers who live in the Bundi Valley. The dam would also devastate the environment, endangering important local species, including fragile populations of bonobo. This raises yet another question. Even if they managed to afford the dam, would it be ethical for the DRC to build it? How do you balance the displacement of locals and damage to the environment against the potential to provide a green energy source to millions of people in Africa? Let us know what you think in the comments down below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.